Hello everybody, my name is Assetto Forza Massimo, also known as FHRC Roni, and today I'm here to show you how to change the oil on the rear differential of a 1990 to 1995 Toyota 4Runner. Now if you go on YouTube and do a little research on how to change differentials on a Toyota 4Runner, you're mainly going to be seeing a lot of 3rd gen 4Runners and above. You don't really see a lot of 2nd gen 4Runners. However, the 3rd gen 4Runner, the way the process goes, works exactly like the Gen 2, but it's a little bit different though, but I'll show you how it goes. Here are the tools that you need. You need a socket wrench and a 24mm socket, and it's always handy to have a breaker bar with you in case if the bolts are quite tight and hard to get out. And you also need the owner's manual. And of course, you need the gear oil and an oil pan. And the reason why I mentioned the owner's manual is you need to know how much oil does the car's rear differential need. In this case, mine's a two-wheel drive only Toyota 4Runner, so it needs 1.9 quarts of oil in the rear differential. So I bought two 80W90 with the API GL5 gear oil for my car. And since we're working with a differential, you should be using the gear oil that is made for differentials, as shown here. Now, since we're working on a 1990 to 1995, basically a second generation Toyota 4Runner, find these two bolts. There's a fill plug and a drain plug. Once you found the fill plug and the drain plug, go ahead and use your 24mm socket and your socket wrench and remove it. Sometimes these two bolts, the fill plug and the drain plug, will be hard to get out, so it's always handy to have a breaker bar with you so you have extra leverage. And as you can see, I am struggling to get this bolt out. So what I did off camera is I use a breaker bar with the 24mm socket to get this bolt out. Once you finish taking off the fill plug, go ahead and remove the drain plug by using the same 24mm socket, and also you can use a breaker bar if you're having trouble getting it out. And once you take it out, out comes the old oil. And as you can see, the oil in this case is still fairly new. It's not really black or anything like that. It's not really dirty, but to be honest with you, I had no idea how long this car's differential was serviced. So just to play it safe, I decided to just change it out. Once both the fill plug and the drain plug are removed, you will notice there are some metal shavings on those bolts. Meaning there's a lot more on the drain plug because there's more metal going in there. And what those little metal shavings, that's actually from the gears themselves kind of like going fine shave. That itself is not a big deal. But if it's like large chunks, that's where it becomes a problem. But in my case, they were still okay, and I didn't really need to worry about it. So after you remove all that oil out of the differential, now it's time to put the new one in. Now, according to the manual, Toyota recommends me to put 1.9 quarts of gear oil in this differential. Now, since I bought 2 quarts of oil, I'm just gonna put all those 2 quarts in. Now, earlier in this video, I did mention that my 4Runner is a two-wheel drive only model. That's why I only need 2 quarts. Now, if you have a four-wheel drive Toyota 4Runner, second generation specifically, you have to put 2.3 quarts. Once you refill your second gen Toyota 4Runner's rear differential back up with 80W90, go ahead and clean up the excess oil that's coming out and go ahead and put the fill plug back in. Once you're done tightening up the fill plug, it's time to go ahead and clean up your workspace and clean up your tools and take the old oil to your local AutoZone or whatever parts store that allows any sort of disposal of automotive oil. Once you're done doing all those last steps, you're good to go. And so that's how you replace the rear differential oil of a 1990 to 1995, basically second generation Toyota 4Runner. Now, like I said before earlier in this video, I've only seen 3rd gen owners doing this kind of tutorial. Now, doing that same process on a 3rd gen will be the same on a 2nd gen. It's just a little bit different as far as the oil capacity for the rear differential, but the basic process is the same. And that's probably why I didn't really see any Gen 2 videos on how to replace your differential oil on the rear. So hopefully you second gen Toyota 4Runner owners find this video helpful. And if you found this helpful, just please let me know. And as always, I thank you guys for watching.